you don't own me. Hi guys, and welcome to today's tutorial. Clearly my tutorial is for Harley Quinn. I love her character in Suicide Squad. Well, I actually haven't seen Suicide Squad, but I love her character in the trailer. I love like slightly crazy movie characters like Helen Bonham Carter, is that her name? I love like all the characters she plays. I just think they're like fun and crazy. I just love them. And I think Harley Quinn kind of fits in that kind of box. This look was super easy to create. I thought it was going to be like fairly easy, but this was like stupidly easy. And I think it's something that you can do for really cheap. The only thing I bought especially for this was the pudding collar and then like hair colour, and that was it. The ribbons I kind of found laying around at home, and all the makeup I already had as well. Oh yeah, my top has tape on it. I forgot that you could see that. Because it actually says carbs and I didn't want it to say carbs, but this is the most Harlequin-ish top I have. It's not really very Harlequin. If I was going out like her for Halloween, I'd probably get the Daddy's Little Monster t-shirt, but I'm unsure if I'm going out for Halloween or not. But without further ado, let's get started with the video. So because I do have dry skin, and I'm probably going to apply a lot of makeup, but let's be real, I'm going to use a Laura Mercier foundation primer, and I'm going to massage that into my face really well, like literally all over the skin. Then I'm going to use the palest foundation I have, which is Born This Way Porcelain. I think this is the palest colour I have. The reason I'm not using white face paint is because I want this to... I still want it to look like real and not like Halloween makeup, if that makes sense. I'm not sure this is the palest, but let's just go with it. Okay, not quite as pale as I thought I would be. But surely porcelain is paler than ivory. And then for concealer, I'm going to use Bourjois Healthy Mix in 51, just the palest one I found basically. Thought I would have loads more pale foundations and concealers, but weirdly I didn't. I'm definitely gonna have to come back into this because the eyeshadow is gonna fall out and I might want to tidy it a little bit. But to be fair, I feel like this is one of those makeup looks that doesn't have to be perfect. And because of that, I'm just gonna really blend that in with a big brush. Gonna go ahead and use my Laura Mercier powder to powder my face. This is a translucent one, I believe. Yeah, really liking this. I've been getting so many comments and like questions about it, even on my Snapchat, which is a little obsessed. Do you feel like I need a bigger puff? I went for a talk with Laura Mercier recently, and she kind of said that you should like massage the product into the puff, and my puff's a bit too small to do that. On to eyeshadow. I'm going to start with my usual primer, which is Too Faced Shadow Insurance. And then because I've got it here, I'm just going to use a little bit of NARS Velvet Shadow Stick in black. I don't know if it's actually called black, but it is black. I'm going to kind of use it on the outer corner. Again, this doesn't have to be neat, but I'm just going to add a bit of depth to the eye. From the film, the left is blue and then the right is red. I have this palette which I use all the time for Halloween. It's so grubby, and it's from Sleek and it's called the Circus palette. I'm going to use some of this, but I might dig into some Urban Decay palettes or something like that. I need to have a look because I do need some other matte ones. I think this blue isn't quite right. So I had a look and I can't find any other blues, so I'm just going to go in with the blue from the Sleek palette. And like I said, the blue is on the left. Actually, because of the black underneath, that blue is probably about the right colour. Just going to keep packing that on. Get bored of basic. No. She's the baddest, straight of vicious, texting her and asking her if she's alone and send some pictures. She said no. What? Well, goddamn. And then apparently on the blue side there are two little splatters of colour. No. Actually, just looking at a still from the film, and it does seem like it goes very much across rather than out than down. And you can just keep packing up this colour and it kind of gets more and more intense. Try to dab instead of dragging the colour. And I've been trying to keep two separate blending brushes. I am blending though, because I think in the film she's actually quite well blended. In the film she does appear to have some sort of black liner or something, so I am going to add liner, but for now I'm just going to use my MAC palette, and I'm going to use Dance in the Dark to add a bit of colour just to the outer corner. It's not quite a black shade though. Harley Quinn's brows are quite thin, but mine aren't. They are, hers are surprisingly dark for her hair colour. If your brows are quite light, then do darken them. But for me, I just use a bit of Benefit Gimme Brow. And I am going to add some liner too. Okay. I might add some lashes, but for now I'm just going to curl my eyelashes and add some mascara. My mascara is the Ciate Wonder One mascara. I really like this mascara. Also, quick note, if you've got a really red blusher, and I mean really red, it works really well as well. This is, again, from Sleek, and this is the blusher in Scandalous. It's one I save for Halloween. No idea. Moving on to the lips, I'm going to use Rimmel Exaggerate Lip Liner in Red Diva, and then I'm going to go in with MAC Russian Red, which is a matte. And I was going to use MAC Ruby Woo, but I think it's too red. This is a little bit deeper, and I like that. Even the lipstick doesn't have to be perfect. So I have added a little bit of pencil eyeliner to my eyes, and then I added a pair of fake lashes. I would recommend, if you are going to add lashes, don't add overly glam ones. I added a pair of glam ones and had to remove them because she's just not overly glam. Well, she's kind of got this, she's like, looks messy. So I think anything too glam looks out of place. Oh my god, I've even got lipstick on my cheek. I'm gonna add a bit of contour, but I really don't want to add any warmth to my face because she's so fair. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this Rhodial one, which is pretty grey, and I'm gonna take that on my Louise Young LY51 brush. I love a bit of highlight, so I'm gonna use the Instaglam Rhodial Compact Deluxe in Illuminating Powder number 1. I'm gonna just highlight the inner corner. End up just down my nose, although she is fairly matte in the film, I think. And that's pretty much the makeup done. I actually quite like it. I'm gonna try and do my hair now. Since it seems everyone's Harley Quinn this year, there's loads and loads of wigs, but because my ends are quite light, they look really dark at the moment, I could probably get away with using the Pixie Lot washout colors, but I'm a bit scared they're gonna stain, so I'm gonna use her hair chalk pens instead, and hair chalks. I'm hoping it'll make it pink enough, but I'm not really that sure, to be honest. But I'll be back in a second with piggy towels, and I also bought this little pudding necklace from eBay. So that's the finished look. I've put my hair in piggy tails, added little ribbons, and then I coloured my ends using these. These were the best things I found. I actually thought they were quite good. The pink looks a bit like bitty, but the blue is pretty good, and I think maybe the pink will get better as it goes on. These are the Pixie Lot paints, and they look like this, and you literally just rub them in your hair. I added the little heart, which is surprisingly hard to draw, and that's pretty much it. Oh yeah, and my little necklace that says put in, and that's the end. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you'd like to see next. I'm tempted to do a few more Marvel ones, maybe like the Red Ivy, Green Ivy, what's it called? Green Ivy, and stuff like that. But I really hope you enjoyed this video. I really had fun making it, and I know, everyone's gonna be Harley Quinn for Halloween, so it's a bit of like a basic bitch tutorial. I just wanna do this with my piggy tails. Anyway, thank you for watching. Like this video if you enjoyed it, and I shall see you all tomorrow. Bye.